Hello everyone, myself Bhumi Patel, Assistant Professor at LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology in the Department of Instrumentation and Control. Today's our topic is different types of science example using the different types of programming timer. Okay, so first of all we know about the types of the timer that we have to discuss in the last session. We have generally two types of timer, non-retentive timer and the retentive timer. What is the non-retentive timer? Whenever the single input is connected for this particular system, that time we can connect the non-retentive timer. But in the everyday industry, there is a not necessary that we have to use only one input. So for that, we have used a retentive timer. In retentive timer, we can use a multiple input for this particular timer application. The must condition for the retentive timer is that we can connect the enable pin and the input pin for this particular timer. And now, the depending upon the application, the retentive timer will be classified into two types, the T on timer and the T off timer. What is the application of the T on timer? The on timer will be used whenever we can on the particular system or the plant for this particular time, that time we can connect the T on timer. And if some application we can off the system after some time, that time we can use a T off timer. Clear? So first of all, we can study the different type of example using the T on and the T off timer. So the first example is there, a timer is to turn on a fan switch 10 seconds after a wall switch is turned on. Okay, if the wall switch is turned off during the 10 seconds, the time interval, the timer is to be reset to 0 seconds so that when the wall switch is again turned on, the delay is full 10 seconds. So first of all, we have to take the input and the output for this particular system. So the timer is to turn on fan switch 10 seconds. Okay, so we have to take the preset value 10 seconds. Okay, now what is the condition after a wall switch is turned on? So wall switch is my input signal. So we can take, suppose name of the input is IN01. Okay, and if wall switch is turned off during the 10 second time interval, the timer is to be reset to 0 second. So the must condition is that we can connect the enable or reset pin for this particular timer timing diagram. So what is the exact logic behind this example is that we have to take one input signal as a wall switch, and the name of the input is that we have to take on IN01. Okay, and compulsory we have to draw the block format in the exam whenever you have to draw the timing example. Okay, so the first condition is the input switch, this is my input. Okay, next condition is we have to connect the enable or the reset pin, and we can take on the name of the enable or reset pin is IN02. Now what is the preset value for this particular example? They will give us the 10 second, and here the format of the timer is we have to write the accumulator register. Suppose the accumulator register is HI01 here, and after that we can connect some output. Okay, so command of the output is suppose T01 and the output name is CR01. Okay, and here we can use a timer on delay. Okay, so what is the condition that is satisfied for this particular program? So a timer is to turn on a fan switch 10 seconds after a wall switch is turned on. Okay, so whenever the input is energized or input is on, my fan will be on. This is my output, and in the output they will connect the fan. So the fan will be on after the 10 second. The second condition is if the wall switch is turned on during the 10 second time interval, that means During the 10 second, if anyone will be off the input signal, that time the condition is there, the timer is to be reset to 0 second. So that whenever the wall switch is again pressed, the timer delay is full 10 seconds. So whenever the timer switch is on, after the 10 second fan will be on. If during the interval, the input will be off, so the timer will be reset for the 0, and the again whenever we press the wall switch again, my reset value will be start from the 0 to 10. So this is very simple program using the timer on delay. Okay, now next example is when switch is turned on, C goes on immediately and D goes on 9 seconds later. Opening the switch turns both C and D off. Okay, so first of all we have to write down the how many inputs and outputs for this particular program. So first of all, when switch is turned on, that means we can take one input switch and the name of the input switch is suppose IN01. Clear? C goes on immediately. That means our first output is C. Okay. Now D goes on 9 seconds later. Means my second output is D. But the condition of the D is D goes on 9 seconds later. So for that we can use the time on delay and the preset value will be given 9 seconds. Now opening the switch turns both C and D off. That means if we can open the switch. So whenever we press the switch, the output will be on. But if we can opening the switch, we can of the output C and D. Okay, so first of all we can draw the logic for the C output. Okay, so first of all we can connect here the input switch IN01, and what is the condition for this C output? When the switch is turned on, C goes on immediately, so we cannot connect the timer for the C output. So simply we can put one input signal and one output, and simply we can write the output name as the switch C because they will give a switch. Okay, after that what is the condition for the D? D goes on 9 seconds later. So for that we have to compulsory use the timer. Okay, now the name of the input is same for the C and D. C will be on immediately and D will be on after 10 seconds. So we have to take the name of the input same for the output C and D. So we can take here IN01. Okay, after 9 seconds, so we can connect here the timer on delay. We can put here the preset value 9. The format of the timer T on is the preset and the accumulator register. And after 9 seconds, which output goes on? The output name is given D. Okay, so after 9 seconds, my output D goes on. Okay, now whenever you draw the block format in the T on or the T off timer, you have to take two input. First for the input switch and the second is for the enable or reset. So you have to mention in the input output format the second enable or reset, and the name of the enable or reset is IN02. Okay, so see here, whenever the switch is placed, output C goes on, after 9 seconds D goes on. Whenever we opening the switch, C goes off immediately. And also we cannot get the input for this particular timer, so D will be off. Okay, so this is the logic behind the example number 2. Now the third example, there are 3 mixing devices on the processing line A, B and C. After the process begins, mixer A is to start after 7 seconds. Next mixer B is to start 3 seconds after A, and mixer C is to be start 5 seconds after B. all then remain on until master enable switch is turned on. So first of all, we have to decide how many inputs and outputs for this particular program. So first of all, here different timers is used. So we can take one input switch and one enable or reset switch. Okay, now there are three mixing devices. So we can take three output, mixer A, mixer B and mixer C. Okay, so we have to start the ladder logic diagram. So first of all, the first condition is that after the process begin, that means the input is energized, mixer A is start after 7 seconds. So we can draw here input IN01. This is my input and the second is enable or reset. Okay, and the preset value is given for the mixer is 7 seconds. So you have to write here in the preset 7 seconds and accumulator register HR01, and here we can use a TR timer because after 7 seconds mixer A will be start. So output of this ladder is suppose A mixer. Okay. The next condition is that next mixer B is to be start 3 seconds after A. So what is the changes for this particular program? Whenever input is energized after 7 seconds A will be on, after A will be on, after 3 seconds B must be on. So the input of the B output must be the input of the first. So we can take here A. We can take here enable pin as it is. This is my enable or reset. Okay, and for the B mixer, the preset value is, sorry, this is my T on timer and this is my preset value, that is given 3 seconds. And we can write here accumulator register HR01, and after the 3 seconds B goes on. Now what is the condition for the C? Mixer C is to be start 5 seconds after B. So same logic we have to continue. After B 5 seconds, mixer C will be start. So we can take B as the input and we can take one enable or reset pin, that is IN02. This is same for all the mixer because this is the processing line and mixer will be depend on each other. So this is my output T on timer. We can take the preset value for this C. It will be given. Yes, it will be given 5 seconds. So we can write here 05 and accumulator register HR01, and this is my output C. Okay, so after the input is energized, after the 7 seconds A will be on. Whenever the A is on, after the 3 seconds B is on, and whenever the B is on, after the 5 seconds C will be on. Now the one more condition is left. Okay, all then remain on until the master enable switch is turned on. So we can take one master switch for this particular program. So we have two options. We can take here the third pin as a input, suppose IN03. We can take IN03 as a master coil or master switch. So we can simply here connect the master switch with the enable or reset, or we can take IN01 as a master switch, that we have to take as a input switch. Why? Because whenever input switch off, that time A will be not on. So A not on, so B must be off, and B will be not on, C must be off. So we can take input switch as a master switch, and also you have to take one another new switch as a master coil, because the condition for this example is then all then remain on until the master enable switch is turned off. Okay, so whenever the input switch will be on, all the mixer will be off. So you can take new master's fee as well as you have to take inputs wage as a master call. Clear? So depending upon the application or depending upon the requirement, we have to use a T on and the T off timer for this particular system. Thank you everyone. If anyone have doubt, then contact me in my email ID.